Good morning, I'm Lauren Moss, a reporter and anchor for Ag Day affiliate WNDU. Clinton has the day off. Happening right now, we're continuing to track a big spike in fertilizer prices. So check out the latest Green Markets North America Fertilizer Price Index. It's now above the $1,000 mark per short ton. That's well beyond the peak set back in 2008. Last year at this time, prices averaged just over $366. The chart uses fertilizer benchmark prices of Gulf Coast urea, Corn Belt potash, and diammonium phosphate, or DAP, the most widely used phosphorus fertilizer. So what's driving these higher prices? Extreme weather, along with rising energy costs in China and Europe, which in turn has forced companies to close or reduce production overseas due to higher natural gas prices. And now, Bloomberg reports some Chinese fertilizer cargoes, loaded and ready to go, are being held up for export as local authorities make additional checks. And we're told a cheaper nitrogen option, anhydrous ammonia, is up 115% in places like Missouri.
I presume farmers are looking ahead and if they're worried about higher prices, trying to access inputs now at prices they think are more reasonable. And to the extent that we have high commodity prices forecast into next year, trying to lock in those high commodity prices. You know, the real pinch would be is if you're locked into high prices and you're trying to sell it, something happens to the market, demand falls, and we're looking at low commodity prices next year, and you've got high input costs, right? I think trying to lock in your margins now would make a lot of sense, would be safe.
Another input cost issue right now, a farmer in Indiana, just south of Chicago, tells us that glyphosate prices are up over 300%. That's if you can get a hold of any.